Hi children, welcome to Educa. Today we are with the second part of Unit 8, Changes in Matter. Today we are going to discuss about chemical changes. So far we have discussed about the nature of physical changes. When a physical change occurs, a change in the composition of substance does not occur. But when the chemical change occurs, new substances are formed. Let's study the nature of chemical changes. We need lead nitrate, a boiling tube, a Bunsen burner. What we have to do, take 1 gram of lead nitrate to the boiling tube. Heat the boiling tube using the Bunsen burner. Record your observation. When white lead nitrate is heated, a brown colored gas is evolved, leaving a red colored powder in boiling tube. The composition of lead nitrate has changed. This is a chemical change. Next practical. We need copper sulfate, an iron nail, a boiling tube, a thermometer. What we have to do, add water and copper sulfate crystals to the boiling tube and prepare a light blue solution. Put the clean iron nail into it. Record your observation. When a clean iron nail is placed in copper sulfate, the solution you would observe that the blue color of the solution decrease. A reddish brown substance deposits on the nail and at the bottom of the vial. The temperature rises. The composition of copper sulfate has changed. This is a chemical change. Next practical. A solution of copper sulfate, a solution of sodium hydroxide, two test tubes. What we have to do, mix copper sulfate solution with sodium hydroxide. Record your observation. When the copper sulfate solution is added to the sodium hydroxide solution, a formation of light blue solid can be observed. Such solids are called precipitates. The composition of copper sulfate solution has changed. This is a chemical change. Next practical. Dilute hydrochloric acid, a zinc granule, a boiling tube. What we have to do, add a little dilute hydrochloric acid into a boiling tube, add the piece of zinc into it. Record your observation. When a granule of zinc is added into the hydrochloric acid, we see that zinc dissolves and gas is liberated. In all of them, new substances are formed. In chemical changes, new substances are formed. Based on the observation made with regard to the chemical reaction stated in these activities, some of the following can be given as the evidence in support of the fact that chemical reaction has taken place in above activities. 1. Evolution of gases. 2. Change in color. 3. Change in temperature. Exchange of heat. 4. Formation of precipitates. 5. Production of sound or light. 6. Production of an odor. The formation of new substance having a different composition over several new substances by one or more substances undergoing changes known as chemical change or chemical reaction. Recall the burning of magnesium again. Magnesium is a metal with silvery luster. Upon heating, it combines with oxygen in the air and forms a white powder. That powder is known as magnesium oxide. The substance that get subjected to change during chemical reaction are called reactants. The reactants of the above reaction are magnesium and oxygen. The new substances are formed by chemical reaction are referred to as products. The products of this reaction is magnesium oxide. This reaction can be shown like this. Let's see some examples of chemical reaction taking place in everyday. Rusting of iron, transition of metals, combustion of materials, decay of organic matter, ripening of fruits, blast of a cracker, digestion of food by enzymes. Now we are going to discuss about law of conservation of mass. What kind of change do you think will happen to the total mass of the substances that are subjected to the chemical changes or chemical reaction? Do you have identified? Let's do this activity to inquire it. We need iron wool, two identical iron wires, a horizontal rod. What we have to do, take two equal masses of iron wool and lump them loosely. Using two iron wires, tie them to horizontal rod as shown in the figure. Suspend the rod on a support of the balance its horizontally. Light one lump of iron wool. Record your observation. Iron wool burns giving reddish sparks. At the same time, the side with the burned wool moves down. Iron wool turns into the product of combustion. The mass increases. Next activity. We need few heads of matches, a boiling tube. What we have to do, put few heads of matches to the boiling tube. Weigh the boiling tube with them. Heat the boiling tube strongly with an open flame until the matches head catches fire. After cooling, weigh the boiling tube with the contents. Record your observation. Here you will be able to observe that the mass after the reaction is lower than the mass before the reaction. When those substances react, there is a chance to combine with some substances in the environment and also release the products of the combustion to the environment. An increase in mass occurred due to the addition of some substances. A decrease in mass was noticed due to the loss of some substances due to the environment. Let's see what is open system. The systems in which substances can exchange between the system and surroundings are referred to as open systems. Closed systems. The system in which the substance cannot exchange between the system and the environment are called closed systems, which have been designed after taking these facts into consideration. We need few matches, a boiling tube, a rubber balloon. Now, conduct this activity in closed system. Close the mouth of the boiling tube containing matches with a balloon. Measure its mass. Apply heat close to the bottom of the tube until the matches light up. Allow the boiling tube to cool and wait again. When the matches burn, the balloon gets inflated gradually. During the reaction, the products are not lost. Also, it is seen that there is no change in the total mass before and after the reaction. Next practical. A conical flask, lead nitrate 1 gram, water 20 milliliter, sodium chloride 1 gram, a boiling tube. Take about 1 gram of lead nitrate into the conical flask and dissolve in about 20 milliliter of water. Take about 1 gram sodium hydroxide to the test tube, dissolve in about 5 milliliter of water and transfer this solution to the ignition tube. Tie the ignition tube with sodium chloride solution with the string and suspend it inside the conical flask containing the lead nitrate solution with the help of stopper. Seal the conical flask by applying Vaseline around the stopper. Weigh the flask with its contents. Slant the apparatus slowly and let the two solution mix. Record your observation. Weigh the apparatus again and notice the mass. Formation of white precipitate on mixing two solution indicates the occurrence of chemical reaction in the apparatus. The result of the experiment also shows that there is no exchange in the total mass before and after the reaction. This is the French scientist Antonio, who conducts many experiments such as above in reaction. To various chemical reactions shown for the first time that the total mass of substances taking part in the chemical reaction. That means reactants is equal to the total mass of the product obtained after the reaction. Later, this finding came to known as law of conservation of mass. Law of conservation mass. During the chemical reactions, the total mass does not change. That means the mass is conserved. Thank you.